finish, isn't it?
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. First leg, Mincer to throw first.
Mincer won the ball out the back and gets the on it to get this one underway. What version of Mincer are we going to see tonight? How will Hempel handle the partisan crowd?
He'll want to impress, I'm sure. Runner-up in this event to Michael van Gerwen back in 2016. Hempel, here for the first time, beat Peter Wright on Thursday, 6-3. And not only scoring heavily as he started here, he also had 50% checkout success, which is handy.
Yes, he was impressive. He was 3 from 3 in the first three legs, and that's where the damage was done.
And the Salzburg crowd pumping up the volume. Bit of musical entertainment, incidentally, while Jackie was having a chat with you. It wasn't exactly the Von Trapp family. It was a bit, bit more raunchy than that. That was Salzburg, you know, Sound of Music.
Take your word for it. This is some start for both. Answer down to 136 after 9. Back-to-back 140s for Hempel.
Well, Jackie posed the question, whose side are they on? And a few jeers and boos for Hempel. I hope that doesn't get too out of control.
We're both impressed. Oh, hang on. Another one of those for double eight. Double eight for a 12-darter and a 136 finish. My goodness.
Goodness me. What a start from Mensel Silovic. Talk about feeding off the adrenaline of the crowd. Certainly is.
Well, it was interesting seeing some of Hempel's post match interviews, and he says the one thing he struggles to deal with is handling his emotions. But I thought he, well, we were both impressed the way he handled the Peter Wright match.
Looked like Joe Cool, didn't he? Didn't look as though he was somebody who was going to about to boil over and start throwing punches or something. He was not remotely like that. But this, tell you what, Silovic is flying.
Yep.
World Cup runner-up in September, Mensor. His first round win was against Adam Hunt.
He's not played a lot of darts over the last couple of years due to, well, of course, the restrictions, but also family health problems. Sometimes a breakaway can freshen things up.
And we all know he's a very good player on his day, isn't he? Very good, as he proved when he won the Champions League back in 2017 in front of the TV cameras.
That had the 8 elite in the field as well, didn't it?
It did. That was one of the great moments, wasn't it, when he went almost went collapsed onto his knees after he'd won that. Producing this sort of performance.
Softest ball shooter in America, the World Championship in 2005 did Mensa, which is very predominantly did prior to moving across to steel tip.
I know you. There are other competing sports which you may be thinking of watching tomorrow afternoon, but I tell you what, if you're just joining us and don't know that in the quarterfinals, the world number one goer in Price is going to be playing Michael van Gerwen. For goodness sake, don't miss it tomorrow afternoon. That could be an absolutely sensational showdown.
Also won the World Series German Masters in 2018, where he defeated the impressive Dimitri Vandenberg in the final with a 101.83, averaged 99.71 in defeating Peter Wright 8-2 in the semi-finals. He was mightily impressive throughout that event.
Well, that was a bit slap-happy from Florian Hempel.
His run from quarters to the final, defeating Rob Cross, who was then world champion, of course, then Peter Wright, and then Dimitri Vandenberg.
Impressive. 48 then for Silovic. Somehow managed to thread that treble in with his last dart of his last visit to set this one up, and now double eight to make it all worthwhile. And he misses by a little way. Florian couldn't bring himself to watch.
An opportunity for an early break and to keep Hempel on the back foot. His finishing was outstanding. It is here.
Pride of Cologne, inland to Cologne. Lovely city.
I don't believe they're out.
One of the great cathedrals of Europe.
You're far more well-travelled than me, JR. Your athletics and boxing, of course, all around the world.
He's settling into it. Mensah was quoted as the favourite for this one, but not as red-hot as you might have imagined.
He was a 4-9 shot.
When you think Gerwyn Price was 1-9, then mine 4-9.
We've seen why, though, didn't we? 103 average in the end. Just shy off.
And Florian's staying with him, blow for blow, just got his nose ahead.
Back-to-back 140s again.
90.
Needs a finish.
Florian's a bit of a Hungarian name, isn't it? I wonder if he's of Hungarian parentage, heritage.
Yeah, he was definitely born in Germany, wasn't he?
64. That sort of thing Dan Dawson will know that.
Ryan McQuarrie, 161.
Well, it can be done. Doors ajar. That's a great first dart. I can't keep it in for the second.
97.
So 115, Chris.
McQuarrie, 115.
He starts on 19s. Could start on the ball. He's going to start on the treble 20. Treble 19 for double 19. No. So a chance for a breaker throw. This time. 55. Florian Hempel.
That's a very real chance as well. 64, looking at the 16s, of course. Needs another, and the boos start. I don't like hearing that.
Nope.
He's not experienced as a top-class darts player, and I guess it's the learning process.
Look how it affects Gerwyn Price.
Yeah.
Way more experience.
Tops then for 2-1 and a hold of throw. That's the wrong side of the wire, mate.
He's walking.
And still the wrong side.
Florian McQuarrie, 16.
Those expecting experience a little bit of agony. Double eight. A good dart. Well done.
Florian
McQuarrie. Cat calls are starting again, and he got it.
Florian the throat first. Game on.
Feel a stronger man and a more resilient man if he comes through this one, Florian Hempel. Totally played a huge amount of the sort of online tournaments that you've been working on, Chris, during the lockdown, Florian Hempel, and did it with a great deal of success.
Yeah, there was plenty of them about, that's for sure. The PDC ran one as well. Apparently, star of lockdown, just to give the players some competitive practice.
The PDC and others served the players wonderfully well through this awful period that we've gone through. And isn't it good to see big-time darts being played again in front of a real celebratory sort of audience?
The players certainly did miss it. Well, maybe not Gezi Price so much.
60.
Well, an opportunity for a break back here for Mensah. She's gone off the boil slightly. This is more like it. Should be a 19. The treble's a bonus.
Perfect dart. He's had one 180 now, a 177.
Didn't like the angle of entry of that opening dart in the treble 20. It was low and just seemed to twist to the right, so it became a bit of a blocker.
Well, he could go for ball, but I don't think he will.
Nope.
No.
97.
Far too experienced. Maybe if he was 9-2 up instead of 2-1 down.
Yeah.
Might have gone out with a bit of a bang.
Double 54. 16 now.
Mensah McQuarrie, 32.
Florian not impressed with that. Double 16 for the break back. And straight away he does it with a 13-darter.
two winning legs. Leg one, that wonderful 1-3-6 checkout, a 12-dart hold, and that was a 1-7-7 in leg four and a 13-dart break back. Winning legs for Florian, then 20 and 16, which is why there's an 11-point gap in the averages. 96.2 Mensah, 85.75 for Florian.
It is a big difference, that. Florian hanging in there. And that's why. Two out of three on his checkout, 67%. Kept him in there.
Good advance today. Outstanding, has to be said. And it's going to continue into tomorrow.
One man out, Fulton.
Gerwin Price has been quoted as favourite when this tournament began, ahead of Michael van Gerwen, but we all heard those words of Michael van Gerwen after his victory. It was fighting talk.
He was
16.
He was definitely up for it.
I'm coming for you. I'm going to regain my place as world number one. It was that sort of sentiment.
96.
I like to hear that. Just gives it a bit of spice, doesn't it? A bit of edge and sets it up.
Yep, certainly makes it lively.
Quarterfinals
tomorrow afternoon, 12:45 ITV4 as usual. Izzy Price against Van Gerwen, Nopper against Aspinall, Cullen against the winner of this one, Rob Cross against De Souza. It's a fabulous lineup.
Yeah, great matches. It's worked out brilliantly. And who's going to emerge victorious from this? Break at the end of this leg. Oh, he thought he got it. He was looking for the double 12. Now Hempel. Break opportunity, Chris.
It was right on the money. It moved the wire. Okay.
54.
Not sure about the double-double.
Agonising. Double 12. So close last time. This time? A little bit of adjustment. Overdone it. Big dart. And the big man nails it. And look how much it means. I can play a bit. A touch of fists and away we go. Hempel trailing, the tall German.
There isn't too many small ones, is there? Well, apart from Martin Schindler. It's the only one I can think of.
Yeah, he's fairly small. You don't see very many small Dutchmen either, do you?
Well, they're the biggest race in the world, aren't they?
Reputedly.
One.
Oh, this is good.
One run of 40.
Only one maximum so far, which went the way of Suljovic.
Yep, and the 1-7-7 as well went this man's way.
One
head in the averages, not by much. Not by a significant amount that make him a huge favourite at this point to run away with the match, that's for sure.
No, it's got the look of a game which is going to go long, hasn't it?
Yeah, he's just going to stick around and make things difficult for Mensah.
Biggest checkout going Mensah's way, 136.
Opening leg. Best leg of the match, 12 darter.
98.
Hempel looking as though he's heading for getting back to parity here.
He went double 18, double, well, he attempted.
And again. Oh, there you are. Chris has got that slightly bemused look on his face where he just for once struggles to get the words out.
Well, okay. That's the way you want to go. Go that way. But long term, it will cost you.
But he's level.
High risk strategy.
One run of Fulton.
Makes good TV, yeah. Though, doesn't it? We enjoyed it. I did.
If you enjoy it, get yourself to an exhibition. You'll see loads of things like that. Not from me.
One run of Fulton.
If you'd see one double 18 that on a mind, well, from me. Good response from Mensah. Back-to-back 140s. Third time he's done that in the match. 140 tally. He's now sitting at 7 to Mensah's 4.
Oh, that's superb dart. First dart looked a bit of a blocker and he just found the way.
He seems to be manipulate the dart through the air.
100.
Couldn't find a third, 140. An easier finish of the two. This one needs two trebles in the combination.
I wonder if Florian will have some bizarre way of going for 1-2-1. I wouldn't be surprised. 100. Silovic leaves it on 36. Right then, he's starting on the ball.
He loves double 18, obviously, which is why he's chosen to go that way, because the treble 20 would have left 36.
Mensah required 36.
Oh, Mensah, he's just shown you where it is. Just put two in there. All you have to do is put one.
Not a problem for Mensah, this. Quite happy with the way this is going now.
Well, we have two holds to throw in legs one and two, followed by two breaks, and now we've had three holds. Mensah leading 4-3, averaging 94.07. Well, credit to Hempel, 94.57 right now.
12 data, 13 and 2.13 data for Mensah. Hempel's best 14 in that sixth leg.
A lovely shot of a lovely shot that was. Fabulous camera angle showing us what Mensah could see from the right-hand side of the hockey.
What Mensah would give for a break of throw here to capitalise on that perfect start. Coming down.
With success. Love another one. Gets one.
One run of 34.
Mensah now going to make his move.
He's in touch with his people, isn't he? He's trying to feed off them.
97.
Yep, his great friend and manager Michael will be down there. A lot of shoulder in that one, Mensah. That's more like it.
Amazing.
Bit unlucky.
Throwing every dart with him at the moment, aren't they? Mensah does win this one.
Willing their hero. Just checking on the score, Hempel.
94. Mensah required.
Phil Cullen will know he's going to be in a match tomorrow. With this crowd.
Throwing well, Joe.
Yeah, good to see.
Oh dear, that's a single 3.
48.
Good thinking, guaranteeing himself.
154.
Two darts at a double, as long as he hits the 19. If he'd have gone for the 20 and it is single, you see, he would have left himself 64, which means he would need a treble to leave, give himself two darts at a double.
96.
So here he goes, 19 first port of call, and now tops for 5-3. Oh, that's unlucky.
19.
Just not dropping in, are they, for him?
So for the hold of throw, tops.
38.
Side of the game that leaves me sad.
Mensah require 40.
I must confess I've never met Florian Hempel, but I'm convinced from what we've seen he's a sportsman and that he doesn't deserve what he's getting.
And that should be decided by a player's ability.
Good dart.
Now we have a break of throw separating the two players.
Serious syrups down there. Plenty of fancy dress.
Lorient finding it all very amusing. Externally, internally, we'll be having a torrid time.
One or two thick heads tomorrow morning, I think.
I should say so.
So Silovic with the break.
They know how to party.
They certainly do. When we were in Vienna not so long back, it was pretty full on there, wasn't it?
Yeah, there was some thick heads there, that's for sure.
Very little between them on the averages at the moment. Silovic has his nose ahead in the match, and that's what counts. You see, just by a couple of points on the scores.
One run on 36.
Good counting, good thinking. So 170, he'll not be going for this. Danny Noppert's got a 170 earlier on today.
Yep. A fabulous last up, had a 167 from Joe Mernon from absolutely nowhere.
100. Mencia requires 70.
And all the time in the world, six darts from here.
He's guaranteed to go into our second break in front.
Beautifully done.
14 darters, three legs on the spin. That's five of the last six in favour of Mencia.
And if the occasion is just getting to Florian slightly, it'll be no surprise.
One man out.
Mensah, a better player than his current ranking tells you. Very yeah. Much better.
A lot of upper body movement. Seems to work on there, that's for sure. Beach is playing on TV, of course, he'll be able to watch himself back. And this is, well...
Don't try that at home.
No.
85. Certainly not with somebody standing behind you, anyway. That's something out of Strictly.
100.
Break at the end of this leg. Silovic, as Chris has already told you, guaranteed to be ahead.
60.
He was 3-2 after the first session, and looking as though he's going to be going in at least 6-4 after two.
And to 10. Does have the darts, of course, in leg 11 when we come back off the break. There will be an opportunity to stretch that lead to 7-4. 40 here would make things interesting.
Not to be. The crowd might just start on Florian again here. Relatively quiet. Double 18. We've already seen indications that that's his favourite. Silovic 156. Nay, he says.
60. Florian require 36.
Double 18. Game show, there it is. So we go to the second break with Russ Bray, and the way he shouts 180 and one, even 140 is Hard to believe what we know, Chris, that he's actually got quite a good singing voice.
Yeah, he can hold a note.
Yeah.
He can hold a note.
And he can sing quite gently as well. It's not, you know, he uses a microphone.
I think he'd do a bit of that heavy rock.
99.
Bit of AC/DC, but no, he likes the Jersey Boys and stuff like that.
Struggle a bit with the Frankie Valli high notes. But
97.
Little Richard Ashdown, that's his number, I think.
On with the darts. Florian is quite having the look of a potential winner at the moment. I know there's not a lot between them, but you just sense that Sulevic has that little bit extra.
Sulevic is the one that under a little bit of pressure. Favourite to win this match, the pressure of the home crowd. Should be ball.
One runner. And he can count. 39.
Beautiful work, got himself onto a finish. So there is an outside squeak of a break of throw.
Oh, 180 here, leaves 24.
What a response, perfect. His third maximum, and what a time to find it. So for 7-4 and a three-leg cushion, double 12.
Three-leg cushion and go within three. A place in the quarterfinals.
13 data.
Vince is winning legs. 12, 13, 18, 13, 18, 14, and 13. It's very, very tidy. There's been some different stuff in between, hence his average is at 94.55. But he's been good. He's been very good.
This Austrian crowd certainly make an effort, don't they? They've all come in their fancy gear.
It's great to see after what's happened over the last couple of years. They're a bit premature.
A bit early, isn't it?
Yes. Not even Halloween yet.
There's a few there, the way they're behaving this evening, they'll look like something from Halloween tomorrow. Probably a few ashen faces. Great darts, his first maximum. Goodness me, launched himself at the board.
That's actually his first maximum of the tournament. Didn't hit one against Peter Wright. Oh, 304 in six. Outstanding.
Beautiful checkout, and just reminding us, yes, I most certainly can throw.
It wasn't a bad leg from Mensah, to be fair. That was a 12 darter.
But it's the break of throw that he needs. Needs the big numbers now.
Three holds a throw away from the win.
16.
He's giving ample opportunities here.
You find a 180. Not happy. Well, there's the show of emotion, which he says he tries to keep under wraps.
39.
Good jump at it.
Much going on the boil at the moment.
Pressure.
Still waiting for him.
Pressure. Forcing everything. Start seeing them low. That's a great adjustment.
Twice.
I've got a feeling there's a twist in this match.
Better find his scoring boots now. Mansour has got him really breathing down his neck. That's wrong side of the wire.
Standing adjustment. Is he going to stay there? He is. Shuffles over a couple of inches more to try and get a line in.
Needed to get a ton here.
Can't leave a finish now.
44.
Not impressed, I think it's fair to say.
Mensah can get away with this leg. It's going to be a huge bonus. He's just checking himself there, Florian. Yeah, Mensah.
Mensah's going to have to fall over the line. Metaphorically speaking, he's almost doing it literally. That's a big ask. He's got a long way to go, but they'd love it if somehow he could pull it off.
A fair bit to go in this match, John.
127, Hempel left on 120, which he might just fancy.
Triple 19. Would have left the ball. Amazed he went that way, considering his love for double 14, and that 20 was such a great marker for the treble.
Needs the treble. He's got it. This for the break back. Oh, just high. I thought that was going to be in.
Tickled the wire. Oh, what a big moment. Might be something we look back on, John, in the next 10 minutes or so, if Mensah can convert, and that was wild.
His arm betraying him for the first two darts, but gets it right in the third. And it's a big, big celebration and quite a sizable sigh of relief, I think. He did seemingly did just about everything possible to lose that leg.
Yeah, that's a 21 dart celebration. That celebration was all about seeing that number 7 turn into an 8.
Two legs needed.
96.
The door was really very much ajar for Florian Hempel, and couldn't capitalise.
It was a great effort, I mean, especially after that first start, finding that smallest of adjustments.
I thought he got that double top. I thought he was in.
Just had that feeling. The averages are so similar that it gives an indication that Florian can just raise it, you know, marginally. He can get himself back in there, and there you go. There's very little between them.
Oh, that's unlucky. That was off the treble wire. Three maximums to one. Silovic has the advantage. Oh, hello.
140.
Hempel's doubling. Well, a little bit superior.
He was outstanding in his opening match, wasn't it?
He was 50% in the first game. Exactly 50% again.
100.
A chance to take this 207 low. Get himself another holder throw and then close the gap to 2 once again.
99.
Well, 108. Silovic should love to get big numbers now. That's a great start. Oh,
130! Only require 100.
Looking at 19s.
Yeah, 4 of them leave double 16. That's the only problem. And created a bit of a blocker. Oh, he went for the double to leave double 16.
51 Silovic.
19 for double 16. Can he go within one?
Double 8 for 9-5. Oh, 31. No. He was willing it in, but it wasn't to be. Hempel then. Can he hold his throw now? Double 16. Yes, he can.
There's an opportunity.
Mensah
to go within one, and he would have had the darts. serve it out right here and now. He's being made to work again.
It's a real scrap of a match, isn't it? Real.
It's going to take a bit out of him.
It'll take a lot of nerve to get across that line. Both men, as the crowd will be on Hempel's case if it gets close. Pair of them swapping ton 40s.
Second 177 to go with the three 180s.
And the cat calling 94. Just beginning again. 184 for Mensah. Could have gone down for the 16s there, elected to stay on 20. Certainly he wouldn't make up much of a poker player, would he, playing in front of his own fans? He's perhaps about as demonstrative as he could possibly be, Mensah Sullivan.
Yeah, good read out of him, that's Mensah, for sure. No, he's feeling.
90.
Could be treble 18. Oh, he's gone for ball tops. May stay there. 65 left. Could go treble 11.
Good dart. Double 16. Just checking it's in. It most certainly is. Double 16 you need, Mensah. Making absolutely sure. As he can.
Pressure turns your mind to mush.
Oh, good dart.
12 dart leg for Mensah.
And they are celebrating as though he's a relation, never mind a fellow countryman.
He opened the match with a 12. I think the watch has come off. The match with a 12. And he's gone within one leg with a 12 darter.
120 grand for the winner of this tournament to be able to afford a watch if he wins it. Very good.
That's up a nice Rolex.
Other makes are available. I think he might have broken his watch.
No, I agree. Oh, there it is. There, the strap's gone.
Oh dear. Again, how, there we go. Oh. Must have been a proper leather strap, just a little bit overworn and getting a little bit soft, mushy.
Looking like Florian's going to make Mensah serve it out. One treble here. Oh, maybe not 61. That one.
Looks rather quizzically at how on earth it's managed to have the temerity to land in treble 7.
Lovely word. Underused.
85. Florian, you require 140.
Ton 40 for the leg. Not now.
Yeah, on the Rob Cross route. Two treble 18s for double 16.
86. And so you require 130.
Double to leave double.
It's a loose dart.
43.
For the treble 19, but it wasn't there, so 54, 18's the target, and again, double 9. Yeah, well done. So, as you predicted, Chris, he is going to have to try and serve it out.
Just want to start this leg big. There's the run of legs from 1 to 10.
85.
since that.
No breaks of throw in the second half of the game.
There's been opportunities.
Plenty. Real test of bottle when you get to this stage.
Yeah, he's just getting over the line in these tight matches.
Bags of experience, which Hempel doesn't have, but that 180 is going to make him feel a whole lot happier. His second, Mansour's had three, plus those two 177s. Ooh, the trouble here. Oh, he's not. He's missed it. Dragged it low.
Hempel has the arrows. Stolen the darts. Stealing a march.
One. First man to a finish.
That's it. Needs something big.
If ever there's a time for a 180, this is it.
100.
No Ryan
run. Require 164.
Just needs to hold it all together here. Brilliant. 101 remaining.
84. Mansour require
156. Has raised the roof if he gets this. Can't be done. It's over the wire. 76 remaining.
100. Florian require 81.
Handled the situation well in the last leg. He's going to get a dart at tops. 50. Well, it should be 20 for double 18, as he loves double 18 so much.
63.
No. Waste any time with
all,
that, did he?
All barring a bit of a disaster. Mansour should get two darts at double 18.
Which he does. Double 18 for the match. Double 9. No, he's dragged it inside, and now he might be in trouble. Is Hempel's nerve going to hold up? Most definitely.
He is fearless on those doubles.
18th though, Florian to throw first.
Still, 50% on the doubles.
Even if he holds his throw here, Siljevic will have the darts in the deciding leg. But you can sort of sense Mansour's nerve ends jangling.
16.
Well, we picked up on it early, didn't we? Didn't think he was just going to run away with this one. No. Just felt like there was a twist.
And it felt like it was one which was going to go all the way. And it may very well do that.
97.
Good cover shot.
Well, when you think that how comfortably Florian has held throw since the 10th leg. Mansour needs troubles. He needs them now. Just trying to dink that one over the top.
Just got the one. It's a bit of a blocker.
One big score from either player will change the 60. Complexion of this leg and match, potentially.
Well, unlucky there, three decent darts. But it wasn't to be. Nothing in it. Siljevic, a big hit here, will make him very much the favourite. Ooh, that's a nervy dart. Dragged it way low.
60.
Looks like he's throwing with somebody else's arm.
Flapping a little bit. This man has looked okay under pressure. There's the first one, and look at the reaction. Mansour's in trouble.
He could well be. He's going to have the darts, assuming he loses this leg. But this will change the landscape. Great time to do that.
What timing that is. Hello. Oh, Mansour, you should get at least one dart here.
16s, he's looking at
already
it.
Already had matched.
Great dart.
Level eight. Two in hand to just literally fall over the line.
For the match. Oh dear. Making you nervous watching it. Never mind how he might be feeling. Double eight. No. Should be a good marker though. No, no, no. Agony for the crowd and his supporters and the man himself. Double 18, loves it here. Yes, it goes to the deciding leg.
He called it early.
The final leg. Mincer the first. Game on.
Whatever else you need to do this evening, don't leave this. Don't do anything else. Just stay with us.
It's going to be dramatic. Is this man's dream going to continue?
Oh, great last dart. Set himself, channel his concentration, get the focus. People in the Salzburg Arena are living every dart, Chris.
Mensa found a magical max in the previous leg, and that's a fabulous 140.
Big visit, that's.
At this stage, under this much pressure, finds a trouble with his final dart just to keep himself interested.
2-1-6. Six darts from here for Mensur Suljovic for the match. One. He needed that last dart. He
needed reaction
to squeeze that in.
Crowd cannot take their eyes off it.
And he's missed out at a key moment, no treble. So Suljovic now has six darts from 116. Surely he can't mess this up, can he?
16 leaves tops to win it in style.
76.
Launched it high.
That was just thrown in the general direction.
Pressure being applied by Hempel.
Turn
40, right, he's probably going to have to get this, Suljovic. 40 needed. 15 darts already in this leg.
Game.
He's done it! He managed to squeeze it in! Camera angle almost blocked it, but look what it means. Sportingly, Florian Hempel applauds. What a dramatic match. Not one of the greats, but what a scrap it was.
The drama, John, it's right up there.
That was terrific television. I hope that wherever you've been watching, you've enjoyed it as much as we have, as much as Mensur Suljovic has. He's almost in tears of joy. What an epic struggle that was. But the Austrian favourite moves on. He gets into the last eight.
it's who you play with. William Hill, sponsors ITV4 Late Nights.